Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Peyton, for those of you who don't know me, and today I'm going to show you how to do waves with a wand. So, if you would like to know how I got these beautiful bouncing curls, then just keep watching. So now that this is hot, I am going to section my hair from like right where your ears are, straight back. I apologize about that fan noise, but it's hot, so fans on. Okay. So I'm gonna take this back section and make sure all the knots are not there. Make sure it's not knotty. And then take the wand in your right hand, hold your hair in your left hand, and then hold the wand down. You don't want to hold it up like this because that's when you get weird looking curls. If you hold it down, it's good. And also make sure you don't touch yourself with it because it's so hot. So what I do is, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm resting my wrist on my forehead. And then just go around and leave some hair out. And this really only has to be on here for like 5 seconds. Bloop. And I know it looks weird, but just let it set like that. And then go to the other side. So when you go to the other side, switch your hands. If you're trying to like do this is like impossible, right hand on the right side. You have to hold it with your left hand. And twist your hair with your right. Don't worry about how your hair like kind of twists. That's what gives it the cool different curl effect than if you were to use a regular curling iron. And then I do my second right at my temples, kinda. Sectioning is really important because it makes sure that you don't get your hair all tangled. It's just a mess. No one likes, it's hard to work. I'm having a morning, guys. Let me drink a coffee sip. Okay. Don't be too worried about the thickness of your section. You don't want it to be huge, but since you're using a wand, wands get really hot, so you don't have to worry about it being teeny. In these front pieces, I always go away from my face, especially when I'm using a wand, because this top part is so skinny, it's just better if you go back. But always remember to leave some hair out at the end. And then just drop it. And now is when I start alternating directions. So that one was away. This next one is gonna be towards my face. And the curls are not gonna all be uniform, but that's kind of what I like about this kind of curl. It's like a weird, wavy curl, more so than like a nice uniform curl. I obviously knew what I'm talking about. Okay. Don't burn your fingers. If your wand comes with a glove, I do recommend using it because burning your fingers is very easy on these. Especially because that's how you curl it, is you're holding it with your finger. Okay, we're switching to the right side of our head, so we're going to start holding the wand with our left hand. And remember to always point it down. And watch out for your ears. Ow. See? Easy to burn yourself. And again, that one was away from your face, so this one goes towards. Doing curls with the wand tends to be a lot more user-friendly because you don't have to worry about clamps or it's literally just wrapping your hair around it. But the biggest mistake people make is holding it upwards like this and not switching your hands. So right side of your head, left hand. Left side of your head, right hand. And don't brush through them yet. You want them to be weird little snakes until the end. But snakes, set them in snakes. And I promise it won't look like snakes. Although, Medusa's a pretty fucking bad bitch. Oh, am I allowed to say that on YouTube? When I get up to the very top section, I don't know why, but I like to start in the back instead of the front. I don't really know why, but that's just what I do. And again, always with these front curls, I curl away. I'm sure someone likes it curled towards their face, but I don't. Also, you do want to make sure there's no knots in every single section, because if you curl it with a knot, it's gonna have a knot, and then you're gonna like try and go through and separate your curls, and you will get your hands stuck because you didn't comb out tangles before you curled it. So, do that. I'm still alternating every curl, one forward, one backwards. It doesn't have to be perfect. If you forget what way you did one, then just, who cares? Just keep going. This isn't supposed to end up looking perfect anyways. My hair personally never stays exactly how I want it to all day long, so I've learned that with my hair in particular, and I mean most hair that I do, I like to make it look more lived in and messy because you're gonna go outside and there's gonna be wind and maybe you'll get hit in the head with a beetle and you'll fling around and freak out and you'll mess up your perfect hairstyle. But if it starts out as an imperfect hairstyle, then you're good to go. You can get hit by as many bugs as you want. Not that you're planning on getting hit by bugs, but there's just been a lot of those bright green June bugs around. My sister says they're blind. And that's all. So, also, don't be mean to them. Don't kill them. Don't hurt them. They don't want to hurt you. But they will eat your figs. So, that's that. Now that this looks like a wiggly noodle poodle. Noodle poodle! I'm turning this off. Safety first, and then you just gotta let this not be hot. Okay, so now that it's cool, there's a few different options. I am going to just kind of mess it up with my hands, but if you wanted a more soft, soft wavy look, then you could go in with a brush, but you're gonna wanna use something that is static free. But anyways, I'm not doing that, so I'm not gonna tell you all about it. I am just going to run my fingers through my hair. Look how big. Anyways, that was a quick and easy little tutorial. See how cute? It's like a mixture between vintage Shirley Temple, Taylor Swift. I think. It's also like mermaid-y. It's a very, I feel, it's a little bit more glamorous. It's like a glamorous beach wave. Instead of the disheveled, super messy beach wave, this one's a little bit more. I already said it 600 times, so why don't I say it again? Glamorous! So this is the end of my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe and leave any constructive comments below. I will link exactly what wand I used in the description box below. If you'd like to follow my Instagram, here's the name. And that's all. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope it was helpful. And I hope you have a wonderful day, a wonderful life, and maybe a burrito. Bye!